Hello students, a very good morning today. And in previous video I have explained the usability test and solved some numerical problems of exercise which is based on 2.2, which is based on usability test of the number, and lots of questions we have solved. Now we are moving our next concept, whose name is prime number. Prime number and composite number and lots of other number also you have to study in this chapter. So let's start. Prime number. So students, this is very important number because lots of number you have studied in this class, just like natural number, whole number, and even an odd number also. So it is also a very important number. If you want to identify that a number is a prime number, so there are some concepts are given in prime number which helps to recognize that a number is prime or not. Okay, so first of all we have to know about which number is prime or not. So a number other than 1, so students, this line is very important. A number other than 1 means 1 ko chhod kar, वन को छोड़कर अ नंबर अदर देन वन, अ नंबर अदर देन वन विच इज डिविजिबल बाय वन आर इट्सेल्फ. Is called prime number. Okay, so it means a number other than 1 means एक ऐसा number जो 1 को छोड़ दिया जाए और वो number या तो 1 से divide हो जाएगा itself मतलब स्वयं से divide हो, then it is called prime number. Okay, so in these type of number mainly you have to know about, in these type of number it has only two factors, or it will be divisible by only two numbers. For example, it first one is 1 and second one is itself. For example, what is the example of prime number? Its example is 2, 3, 5, 7, 9 is not a prime number. So student, 9 is not a prime number because 9 has lots of factors. For example, 1, 3, and 9. Okay, so for prime number, a number for being a prime number, it has only two factors. First one is 1 and second one is itself. So 9 is not a prime number. So after 7, the next prime number is 11, 13, 17, and so on. Okay. So in these type of number, these examples are prime number. Why? Because all the numbers have only two factors. First one is 1 and second one is itself. We have to check. So this is the example of prime number. Now we are moving on next definition. It is called composite number. Okay. So students, composite number is the opposite of prime number. If you want to say that in composite number, you have to say in one line that it is the opposite of prime number. Or you also say that a number which is not a prime is called composite number. So a number which is not a prime is called composite number. Or another example of composite number is, or you have to write that is a number which has more than two factors. A number which has more than two factors is called composite number. So students, this is the definition of composite number, and the example of composite number is 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 15, and so on. So these are the examples of composite numbers. And why these examples are composite numbers? Because if you check the factor of all these numbers, then there are more than two factors, because 4 has 3 factors, 1, 2, and 4. 6 has 3 factors, 1, no, 4 factors. 6 has 4 factors, 1, 2, 3, and 6. So all these numbers are examples of composite number, and it has more than 2 factors. So it is known as composite number. Okay, students? Now, some interesting facts are also given for composite and prime number, that 2 is the smallest prime number. 2 is the smallest prime number, and it is only even prime number. So students, the interesting fact of prime number is 2 is the smallest prime number. It means if anybody asks that what is the smallest prime number, then we have to say that 2 is the smallest prime number, okay? And also 2 is the only even prime number. It means there are lots of numbers in which only 2 is the even prime number, and rest of all are odd prime number. So 2 is the only even prime number. Now, second interesting fact is this is the part of this notes is the smallest composite number is 4. Okay, so students, If anybody asks that what is the smallest composite number, then you have to say that 4 is the smallest composite number. So these are all the important concept of composite number and prime number. So students, please pass the video to note it down in your copy or take a screenshot. Now students, moving on next definition, it is called co-prime number. So in this definition, if two numbers have only one as the common factor, then it is called a co-prime number. If the two numbers have one as the common factor, then it is called composite number. Okay, so students, this is very interesting about that. It is not necessary that two numbers, if you take two numbers and you have to say that both the numbers are co-prime number. So it is not necessary that both the numbers are prime number. An even or odd number also be a co-prime number. For example, two, three, four, six, 11. 7, 11, etc. So students, look here, the examples are for prime number. In this prime number, both the numbers are prime number because 2 is the prime number and 3 is the prime number, and 2 and 3 has only one common factor, so it is called co-prime number. But in this example, 3 is the prime number and 4 is the composite number. But both the numbers are co-prime number because both the numbers has only one common factor. So both the numbers are co-prime number. So it is not necessary that if you want to say the example of co-prime number, then it is not necessary that both the numbers are prime number. It can be a prime number and as well as composite number also. So student, there is no confusion between the example of co-prime number. It can be both the numbers are prime number and also both the numbers are prime number and composite numbers. In the same way, here 6 is the composite number and 11 is the prime number. So this is the example of co-prime number. Now next definition is twin prime number. So students, two twin prime numbers means if you take two prime numbers and the difference between two prime numbers is only 2, then both the two prime number is called twin prime number. if the two prime number have the difference have the difference only two, then both prime number is called twin prime number. So students, it is also very interesting number that if you want to say that two prime numbers is called twin prime number, then you have to check that the difference of both the prime number is 2. If 2 is not the difference of both the prime number, then it is not a twin prime number. For example, five and seven, 11 and 13, and so on. So students, all the examples are two prime number, because if you want to find the difference between both the prime number, then we will get 2, because 5 minus 3 is equal to 2, 7 minus 5 is equal to 2, 13 minus 11 is equal to 2. So all these numbers are examples of twin prime number. And if you take 11 and 17, then the difference between 11 and 17 is 6. The difference between 17 and 11, both the numbers are prime number, but the difference is 6. So it is not a twin prime number. So for twin prime number, the example of prime number is that both the numbers have difference only 2. So student, pass the video to note it down in your copy or take a screenshot. Now student, the concept is over and we have to solve the exercise of 2.3, which is based on all these concepts which I have given today. So first question of exercise 2.3 is in first question it is solved by yourself, because in first question you have to make a list of all the prime and composite numbers from 1 to 100. So student, you have to make a list of prime and composite number from 1 to 100, and it is given in your book in this page. So student, it is because I have given the concept of composite and prime number, so it is very easy to check that in from 1 to 100 which number is composite number and which number is prime number. So you can take help from this page, okay, and it is very easy to say that which number is a composite number and which number is a prime number. Now we are moving on to next question. Which number is neither prime nor composite? So student, I know you are all know about the answer of this question. Only one is the number which is not a prime nor a composite number, because one is the only number. You can't say that it is not a prime number and it is not a composite number. So the answer of this question is 1. Now we are moving on to question number 3. What is the smallest prime number? What is the what is the smallest prime number? So student, I have given also the answer of this question in the notes, that 2 is the smallest prime number and the answer is 2. 2 is the smallest prime number. 2 is the smallest prime number and also 2 is the only a number which is even, and both rest of the number is not even, and so it is also known as 2 is the smallest prime number as well as 2 is the only even prime number. Okay. Now question number 4 is also the concept of notes of today I have given. How many even numbers is prime? How many even numbers is prime? So today I have given also the answer of this question, that 2 is the only 2 is the even prime number. How many even number is prime? So only one even number is prime. Only one even number is prime, and which is 2. And the answer is only one even number is prime, and which is 2. Okay, so student, this is the this question is based on the your notes which I have given in previous lecture. Now student, we are moving on next question. What is the smallest composite number? Question number 5 is, what is the smallest composite number? So student, the answer of this question is also very easy, because I have given in the answer of this question in the notes after the definition, that what is the smallest composite number. So you are all know that 4 is the smallest composite number, and the answer is 4. So students, take the screenshot or pause the video to note it down in your copy. Now students, we are moving on next question. Question number 6 is, you have to find out the following numbers are prime or not. So students, I have told in the definition of prime number is, prime number has only 2 common factor. It is 1 or itself. So if you find the numbers have more, how many factors of this number? So first of all, you have to apply the divisibility test, and if you add the even and odd places number and find the difference, then we will get 7 plus 1 is equal to 8, 8 minus 8 is equal to 0. So it shows that this number is divisible by 11 also. This number is divisible by 11 also, because 11 1 is 11 and 11 7 is 77. So it has more than 2 factors. It has more than 2 factors, because 1 is the factor, 11 is the factor, and also 187 is the factor. So it is not a prime number. So it is not a prime number. So the answer is A is no. And in this B part, it has only 2 factors. That is 1 and 149 means itself. So it is a prime number. And also in this part, it has also 2 factors only, 1 and itself means 277. So it is a prime number, but D is not a prime number because 3 to 9 is divisible by 7. 7 4 is 28 and 7 7 is 59. So it has more than 2 factors, means 1, 7 and 3 to 9. So it is not a prime number, okay? So students, these are the questions which I have solved today, and I apply the concept of prime number because without applying concept of prime number we can't solve any question. So students, first of all we have to memorize or learn all the definition with the concept, with the example, and do question number 1 of exercise 2.3 by yourself. I have given the hint, and I hope you are all understand today I have delivered, and in next video I will solve the some remaining question of exercise 2.3. So thank you very much.